Recent headlines have been dominated by eastern blizzards, unprecedented snowfall in the Midwest, and record-breaking cold temperatures across the Plain States. But has any of this precipitation reached the major river basins in the West? You're about to find out. Hello and welcome to Time Bomb. In this episode, we're exploring the snowpack in the western and southwestern United States. First up, the Colorado River Basin. Next, we'll shift our focus over to California and explore the Sierra Nevada region to see how their snowpack is doing. You're watching Time Bomb. Remember to hit that like button. Let's get started. You may be wondering why I pay so much attention to the snowpack. After all, this isn't a ski channel. We focus on water crisis here. Well, approximately 70 to 80% of the water in key rivers like the Colorado, Sacramento, and Feather is sourced from snowpack and the resulting runoff. In fact, more than 30% of California's entire water supply comes from snowpack. As you know, many of these rivers, including the Colorado, Sacramento, and Feather, have experienced record low water levels in recent years. This is due to a number of factors, including overallocation and gross mismanagement. To accurately predict how these rivers will fare throughout the year, it's essential to monitor the snowpack closely. When we measure snowpack, we use the term snow water equivalent. Snow water equivalent is the amount of water contained within the snowpack that would result if the snowpack melted. For example, if a column of snow covering a specific area is melted, the depth of water that collects would be the snow water equivalent. We measure snow water equivalent in inches of water depth. This helps us determine how our rivers, and more importantly, how our reservoirs will be impacted during the spring snowmelt runoff. This is a map of the entire Upper Colorado River Basin. It shows the snowpack levels in the 10 river basins that together form the Upper Colorado River Basin. It also shows the capacity for each of the 7 major reservoirs located in this region. Now let's take a look at the snowpack. Oh, and by the way, I placed a link to this map in the video description for your reference. Let's start up north with the Upper Green River Basin. The Green River is the largest river that feeds into the Upper Colorado River. In this basin, the snowpack currently stands at 62% of median. Oh, one thing I want to point out is that the snowpack percentage is the median for the 30-year period from 1991 to 2020. That is the most recent 30-year period following a standard set by the World Meteorological Organization. They do not use the last 30 years, but the last 3 decades. So 10 years from now, when you're still watching this channel and I'm still making videos, I'll be using the 2001 to 2030 date range. Looking at this chart, we see the current snowpack represented by the black line. You notice it is below the green line that represents the minimum projection. The minimum projection is the least amount of snowpack that can be expected under current forecasts from the Bureau of Reclamation. This means the actual snowpack as it stands right now in the Upper Green River Basin is significantly lower than what was forecasted by the Bureau of Reclamation to be the lowest possible level at this time of year. This is not good at all, but let's move on. Here is a chart for the Lower Green River Basin. The snowpack is currently 64%, which is terrible. It's way below the median for this time of year, but at least it's still within the range of predictions. Next up, we have the White Yampa River Basin, which is sitting at 73% of median. Let's look at the chart. As you can see, this winter's snowpack is bouncing along real close to that minimum projection line we discussed earlier. Again, this is not looking good for the flow of the Colorado River later this summer. Moving south, we have the Colorado River headwaters. This basin covers the area where the Colorado River begins up in the Rocky Mountains. And here's the chart. Okay, the headwaters basin is currently at 75% of median. You can see the black line is flat for the month of December. there was just not that much snow at all in this region through the whole month of December. Hopefully things will pick up. Now let's head a little west to the Upper Colorado region. The snowpack here is 70% of the median for this time of year. And now let's see the chart. Again, that black line is just off of the minimum projection line. I think we're starting to see a trend here. Moving south, we arrive at the Gunnison River Basin, where the current snowpack is at 76% of median. Let's see the chart. At 76% of median, the Gunnison River Basin is actually doing much better than the other basins, but it's still only in the 14th percentile for its historic snowpack. Moving west again, to the southeast portion of Utah, we run into the Dirty Devil River Basin. The snowpack in this region is the worst in the Upper Colorado River Basin area. Let's see that chart. Wow, the snowpack is only at 60% of median for this time of year. However, as you can see, it's not unusual for the Dirty Devil Basin to get a late start in regards to snowpack, so there is still some hope left for this basin. Now let's move back east to the Dolores River Basin, where the snowpack is sitting at 75% of median. Now let's see the chart. Although the snowpack is only 75% of median, it is well above minimum projections. Hey, that's something. At least the forecasters can feel good about that. Now, back to the map. Next up, we have the Lower San Juan River Basin. This is our outlier. Let's see the chart. Wow, okay. So the current snowpack is spot on with 100% of median for this time of winter. Let's hope that trend continues. Back to the map, where we have our last basin, the Upper San Juan River Basin, which is actually south of the Lower San Juan River Basin. And here's the chart. The basin is currently at 73% of median, making this region one of the better performing in regards to snowpack. Now there are, of course, other rivers and tributaries that constitute the Upper Colorado River Basin. When taking in its entirety, the snowpack for the entire Upper Colorado River Basin is currently just 65% of the median for this time of year. Now, there's still about 90 days left before the median peak snowpack. That's usually in early to mid-April. Things may look terrible at the moment, but there is plenty of time left in the winter season for things to turn around. However, the way the numbers currently stand, the water resource planners at the Bureau of Reclamation need to start planning for another year of record low flow in the Colorado River. Now let's switch our focus over to the California Snowpack Report. The California snowpack is divided into three main regions for monitoring purposes. We have the northern, the central, and the southern Sierra Nevada. Approximately 60% of the state's water originates from the Sierra Nevada snowpack and the watershed systems associated with these mountains. Now let's take a look at the report. In the northern region, the snow water equivalent is currently 6.2 inches. That's just 48% of average for this date. In the central region, the snow water equivalent stands at 5.7 inches, giving us a 46% of normal for this date. And in the southern region, we have just 3.1 inches of snow water equivalent. That equals out to just 31% of normal snowpack for this date. This is an absolutely terrible start to the year. Last year at this time, the snowpack was at 205% of normal. Again, there's still 2.5 months left in the snowpack season, and a few large snowstorms could change the situation significantly. Yes, this channel focuses on water crisis, but we do not hope for or look forward to water crisis. The point of this channel is to bring attention to the overallocation of our nation's water and how it has been mismanaged for generations. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know in the comments section. As always, thank you for watching. I'll be back with another video next week. In the meantime, please consider subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate your support.